this lecture, we are going to discuss about principle of operation of a tunnel diode. So for this, first let me draw the energy band diagram of a tunnel diode. So this is a P doped semiconductor or P side, and this is N side. This is the position of the Fermi level after making the junction. So this is EV, that is maximum of the valence band for P side. This is minimum of the conduction band, and similarly this is EC for N side and this is EV for N side. So here we can see that this is the width of the depletion region, that is we can assume it W naught. So here the built-in potential energy is equal to this gap, that is Q VB, where VB is the built-in voltage. If this is easy, then we can write it as in volt as VG. So here we can see that VG, VB is greater than VG. Built-in potential or built-in voltage is greater than the energy gap equivalent voltage. So now we can draw the density of filled state in N side and density of empty state in P side. So if we draw these, so in N side we can have blue color, it so the density of filled states look like this one. So these are the filled states, and similarly in P side these are the density of empty state, just opposite to this one. So these are empty states. So all these states are filled here in P type, here and also here. So these all states are filled, but in P side only these states are empty in valence band. And for N side, these states are filled in conduction band. So now let me write some lines here. We know that the two sides, of the junction are heavily doped and the Fermi level is located inside the allowed bands on both sides. So as we discussed yesterday, that tunnel diode is made by degenerate semiconductors. So here both of these P side and N side are degenerate semiconductor. That's why their Fermi level lies inside the allowed energy bands. That is in valence band for P type semiconductor and in conduction band for N type semiconductor. Consequently, the built-in voltage that is VB of the junction is larger than the voltage VG corresponding to the band gap of the semiconductor. At a finite temperature, we can see the distribution of field states. As I mentioned, there are some field states in the conduction band, and opposite to that, there are some empty states in the P side in its valence band. So in the conduction band, on the N side, there is a small number of occupied or filled states but a large number of empty states. The situation is just reverse in the valence band on the P side, where a small number of empty states face the occupied states of the conduction band on the N side. So in this diagram, as I mentioned earlier, that is, there are few filled states in the conduction band, but other states are empty. But in P side, that is, there are some empty states and other states are filled. Both of these shapes are equally nature. So this is opposite of this. So here we can see that these empty states are facing the filled state of this N side. This is very important, because when this junction is made, these electrons start to move towards this P side to fill these states. So I will mention it here. So I have written that of empty states face the occupied states of the conduction band on the N side. The electrons from the occupied states in the conduction band on the N side can tunnel into the empty state in the valence bands. On the P side, through the forbidden gap, that causing a flux of electrons from the N to the P side. However, the conventional current ICV flows in the opposite direction. So, in this diagram, we can see that these field states in the conduction band of N side are facing the empty states in the P side. So, since these are degenerate semiconductors and this depletion width is very small, or the thickness of this depletion layer is very small, so these electrons can tunnel to this side. So, in this way, electrons from this side tunnel to this side. But we know that the sign of the conventional current is just opposite to the movement of the electrons. So here we can see that the conventional current is going in opposite direction. So this is the direction of the conventional current ICV. And it's very easy if you are getting confused to see these field states and these empty states here. This is nothing, but only we have to apply the formula that what is the number of density here by using Fermi-Dirac formula, by putting the value of this doping and energy, we can get these states. And at the same time, by applying the formula for holes, we can get these empty states. And when we draw that states with respect to energy, we can draw this diagram easily. So here the electrons are tunneling to the P side. So due to this tunneling, we can get a current which is equal to ICV. And at the same time, Similarly, electrons from the occupied states of the valence band on the p side tunnel into the empty state, empty states in the conduction band on the N side. That constituting a current IVC. And it is important to note that under thermal equilibrium, IVC exactly balances the ICV. So this is a scenario when we are not applying any voltage. So this is the IVC current. So here we can see that these are field states in P side, and we can see that corresponding to these states in P side, these states are empty in the N side. So these electrons from N side will tunnel to this empty state in P side, and these electrons will tunnel to the N side from the P side. So in this way, these movement of all of these are balancing to each other. That is, the same amount of current is going to this direction and same current is going to in this direction. So when there is no bias voltage, then this current is zero, or the net current is zero. So we can write here that this is at zero bias voltage, और जस्ट 0/22। नाउ लेट्स अप्लाई ए रिवर्स बायस टू दिस टनल डायोड। Reverse bias. So now let me draw the energy band diagram again for reverse bias. So for reverse bias, we apply a positive voltage to the N side and negative to the P side. So now we are applying a negative to the P side, negative voltage to the P side and positive voltage to the N side. So now there is no thermal equilibrium and due to apply of a positive terminal to this N side, due to this applied voltage, the energy bands in the N side will go towards in downward direction. So here we can see that all the states here are filled and all the states below this Fermi level in P side also filled. So we can see that this is the EFP, that is Fermi level for P side, and this is EFN, and this difference we can write as QVA, which is equal to the applied voltage. So this is EC and this is EV. And again we can see that this is the depletion width, that is W. So now let's see what's happening here. Here we can see that there are empty states in the N side. So electrons from the valence band of the P side now tunneling to the N side. So let me write here. So in this situation, reverse bias. I am not showing any battery here. So in this situation, a large number of valence band electrons on the P side face a लार्ज नंबर ऑफ एम्प्टी स्टेट्स इन द कंडक्शन बैंड ऑफ द और कंडक्शन बैंड ऑन द एन साइड. On the other hand, the electrons in the field states of the conduction band on the inside face only the field states in the valence band on the P side. It is very important to note that here we can see that these are field states. These are also field states. So here we can see that these field states of the P side are facing a large number of empty states in the conduction band of this N side. But here we can see these all states are filled. That the field states of this N side are only facing the field states of the P side. So there is no tunneling of electron from N side to P side. But since these states are facing empty state in N side, so electrons can tunnel from P side to N side. And due to this tunneling of electrons, there is a large amount of current is flowing from N side to P side. Here electrons are moving from P side to N side, but our conventional current is moving in opposite direction. So actual current is going from N side to P side. So in a reverse bias, we can see a large amount of current. So consequently, electrons tunnel from P to the N side while tunneling in the opposite direction becomes impossible. Thus, the current IVC becomes large and increases rapidly with the bias. While ICV tends to zero, this causes a net current from N to the P side. So, as I mentioned in earlier class, so this is applied voltage, and when we apply a reverse bias voltage, we can get a current like this, that as we increase the applied voltage, this current increases rapidly. So this is for reverse bias condition, that is condition A. Let me draw its complete IV characteristics. So this is like first it will get its maximum point, then again it starts to decrease, and after getting its minimum point, it will again start to increase. So this is its minimum value, and this minimum value depends on many things. In last lecture, I draw this line very near to this line, and it looks that the minimum value is becoming zero, but it will not be zero. It is minimum, but it will not be zero. So here I only mean that this is its minimum value, and this minimum value depends upon many things, upon material and doping. So this minimum value can be here, or maybe in some point can be here, but this is a general graph. So this curve is B, and after this is C, and this is D. So this is its maximum current, that is IP, at a voltage VP, and this is its minimum value at a voltage VV. So I think this is all about for zero bias and reverse bias condition. In next class, we will see the tunneling current in forward bias condition.